Hi, my name is Yogesh Joshi, and today we are at Startup Masterclass, which is an interesting initiative, a get-together being organized by IIT Kanpur alumni at IIT Kanpur campus. And we have with us Mr. Animesh Srivastav. You are the partner for a company called the Massive Earth Fund. So, welcome Animesh.
Yeah, hi.
And can you tell us a little bit about what this fund is all about?
So, Massive Fund, at Massive, we are looking at areas of any startups that are working in areas of sustainable future. So, what we are looking at is basically something, all the startups that can work in areas of, you know, clean mobility, energy storage, renewable energy, air, water, waste. So anything that has primarily got to reduce the carbon emissions in the world and lead the world towards a sustainable future.
Okay.
That is primarily what we are looking at. In terms of size of the fund, it's a pretty new fund. We announced in June of last year. We are still in the process of announcing the first close. But the size is a $150 million fund. That is what we are looking at. And the reason for this kind of a large size is that, you know, we believe that these are like big problems that need to be solved. And low amount of capital is not going to solve it. We want to deal with startups which are at an early stage, even at Series A and Series B. And therefore, we need this kind of a size of a fund.
So
that's the whole thesis behind
that. I see. So amongst the, you know, four or five verticals that you spoke about, which is the largest or which is the hottest one as per your estimation for a market like India?
I would pick two. See, all these problems are actually very large. If you look at air pollution, for example, right? If you look at water, for example. So India is a hugely water deficit country in those terms, right? We have like 54% of India is facing water stress. So all these problems are pretty large. It would be difficult to pick any one which would be like largest, but I'm definitely very much bullish on electric vehicles, electric mobility in that terms, and as well as on agriculture.
Okay.
So because again, primarily India is more or less we are an agrarian society, right? So lot of challenges, massive things that can be done there, and therefore I think these two areas, if I had to primarily pick up,
so
water, clean mobility, and you know, agriculture would be the two ones.
Okay. Big ones, yeah. And on the EV side of it, can you talk a little bit about, you know, how has been the industry, or you know, what has the future of this kind of a technology in India?
So EV, I believe, has a good future. This is something that we definitely need in India, because if you really look at India, primarily unlike other countries, we are primarily dominantly a two-wheeler kind of a market, right? And two-wheelers, unlike four-wheelers, they are not subject to that kind of a pollution control norm. So for four-wheelers, you have Bharat Stage 1, BS3, BS4 coming up and all those. Two-wheelers primarily don't have these kind of stringent pollution controls. So India is at a very good point, because replacing a two-wheeler with an electric two-wheeler is far easier to do than, you know, getting a car replaced. So we are bullish on electric two-wheeler startups. We are bullish on battery startups. We are bullish on any startup which is working in vehicle intelligence, connected vehicles, and these kind of stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see. And from a policy and regulatory standpoint, how do you see the government, you know, supporting this technology, or let's say the sector in the coming times, or the current, what is the current state?
Okay, so see, government has made some, I would say, decent, you know, initiatives in terms of the national, you know, clean mobility program. But yeah, there have been flip-flops at times. For example, there was an announcement for the charging and everything. So they came up with different standards, which was one, the Bharat AC1001 standard, and then they came up with the Bharat DC001 standard, and then those standards got scrapped, and then we had, you know, different kind of CCS. And so I think in terms of charging, that is one area where government really needs to take a stand now, in terms of, you know, what kind of charging we want to go ahead with, and we need to take down any kind of regulatory hurdles.
Okay.
So even for example, lithium ion, for example, even today in India, you cannot order lithium ion cells online.
Okay.
Yeah, you cannot. So how is a startup who is, let's say, working on a new battery pack or a battery management system, how are they supposed to get lithium ion cells? So I think there are a lot of areas that government can work on.
Okay. Yeah. Wonderful. You know, since you are here, participating, representing, you're chairing, you know, panel sessions which are on smart and, you know, smart infrastructure side of the industry sectors. Mm-hmm. What's your message for this startup community, you know, as to how can they embrace these upcoming or, you know, hot technologies going forward?
So our message to startups in, you know, in any case, does not normally depend on what sector they are playing in. Mm-hmm. Our message is normally universal. You are a startup, you have to, one, figure out a really large problem to solve. Mm-hmm. And we believe these are like really large problems. I mean, we would see, and unlike online where, you know, it's a winner-take-all market, mm-hmm. in electric mobility, in agriculture, in air, water, mm-hmm. it's a physical market. So there is mm-hmm. a space for multiple billion-dollar companies in these sectors. Mm-hmm. So one, these are large problems, work on it and do some deep science. I mean, rather than just, you know, doing some kind of a shallow work, mm-hmm. getting, you know, kits imported from China and, you know, assembling them, mm-hmm. work on some deep science. So for mm-hmm. example, if you're on battery, just look on the chemistry of the battery. I mean, they have come up with, you know, LFP is there, NMC technologies are there. Mm-hmm. Think about whether we can build some new technology, you know, new chemistry in itself that increases maybe the efficiency or the life cycles of the battery. Mm-hmm. So we definitely have a preference for startups which are working on deep science.
Okay.
Yeah. And a large problem at the same time.
I see. Yeah. And any key takeaways from forums like these where what you could take back and, you know, try?
Hmm. Yeah, definitely. I think initiatives like these are great in terms hmm. of, one, bringing together the whole ecosystem of, you know, the startups, the investors, mm-hmm. the academia, because mm-hmm. we all need to work together to solve these challenges. Mm-hmm. So initiatives are great. We get to meet a lot of interesting startups. Startups need to, you know, bounce up ideas along with investors. Mm-hmm. So I definitely, I'm all on for it. Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
One last question, Animesh.
Yeah.
So where do we see this, you know, massive Earth Fund in the next 3 to 5 years from now?
So one of the key investment thesis that we carry on at Massive is that we are not looking for an early exit, because mm-hmm. we understand these are like large problems, these will take time to solve. So one, even our typical life size of a fund would probably be 7-8 years. We are looking at a 12-year kind of a lifetime, right? Mm-hmm. So having said that, probably we believe that we would be able to exhaust this kind of fund that we have over the next 3 years, and probably around the next 5 years we would be looking at maybe a 3x or a 4x larger fund. So maybe our mm-hmm. next raise could be around, you know, 500 million kind of fund.
But
essentially what we want to do is we want to bring capital and we want to bring the policy advocacy along, and we mm-hmm. really want to help startups in any whatever way we can, right? Mm-hmm. And we want to solve problems for India.
Okay. Yeah. Wonderful. That's a great mission, and we wish you all the best,
you.
As well as your team
sure,
in achieving
thanks.
That.
Thanks.
Pleasure talking to you. Thanks.